Hello, welcome to the session of magnetic field intensity for infinite length filament. Learning outcomes: at the end of this video, you will be able to apply Biot-Savart's law to derive magnetic field intensity for infinite length filament. You will be able to determine the direction of magnetic field for a given filament. You will be able to calculate the magnetic field intensity for infinite length filament for the given conditions. Now, before I start, I want to ask you to recall the equation of Biot-Savart's law. As we want to apply the Biot-Savart's law, please recall the Biot-Savart's law which we have already seen in the previous video. I hope you got the equation of Biot-Savart's law. Biot-Savart's law can be given as h bar is equal to closed line integral of idl bar cross ar bar upon 4 pi r square. Of course, the unit of magnetic field intensity is amperes per meter, where I stands for current, dl is a small section of the filament, small length of the filament, and AR bar is the unit vector in the direction of R bar. And what is R? R is the distance between the filament and the point P where we want the magnetic field. And in between, this symbol is not a simple multiplication. This is a cross product. H for infinite length filament we want to find out. For that, I'll consider the XYZ axis, three-dimensional coordinate system. And let us assume an infinite length filament like this, and I'll consider that the current I is flowing through this infinite length filament. And at the same time, I want to tell you that here our intention is to find out the magnetic field at point P in the xy plane. The point P has coordinates r, phi, 0 in cylindrical coordinates. Why r, phi, 0? Because point P is at certain radius from the origin. So r, as point P passes through some plane, so that is phi. And as it is the xy plane, here assume that z equal to 0, so this coordinate is 0. So the coordinates of point P are r, phi, 0. Let us assume a small section of the filament having length dl bar. Why small section? Because when the filament is of infinite length, for this infinite length, I cannot find out h bar instantaneously, or rather, I need to find out small section dh bar, that means the magnetic field intensity for this small section, and then I'll sum up or integrate all these sections so that I get h bar for infinite length filament. Let us consider the point where I have considered the small length of the filament. That point is 0, phi, z. How the coordinates have come as 0, phi, z? Because radius at this point is 0, because it is the point is on the z axis. Phi, because the filament passes through some plane, phi, and z as it is from origin at certain height, so that the coordinate is z. Let us join this point with the point P because we want to find h bar or magnetic field intensity due to this infinite length filament. So after joining these two points, I should put the arrowhead towards point P. Why towards point P? Because I need to find the field at point P. Where we want to find the field, at that point the arrowhead should be there. The distance can be denoted as R bar. I'll consider the same diagram here and let us start deriving the equation for H bar. I have written a Biot-Savart's law. dH bar is equal to idl bar cross ar bar upon 4 pi r square. The same equation is repeated. Only the thing is, I am finding out for this small length, I have omitted the integral sign. And beyond that, I have written as a dH bar because it is for a differential length of the filament. dl bar. Here, in this case, I need to find out the unknowns from this equation. In this equation, the unknown is dl bar. I is current, as we know, some value is given. But what is dl bar? What is ar bar? 4 pi is a constant, and what is r? These things we need to find out. So out of that, dl bar here is dz az bar. Why it is dz az bar? Because the filament is placed along z axis, which is ranging from minus infinity to plus infinity. But when I consider a small section of the filament, which is dl bar, it comes to be dz az because it is along z axis. When I multiply it with I dl bar can be given as I dz az bar. R bar is the head coordinate minus tail coordinate. R bar is this vector. For this vector, how I can find out R bar? It is the head coordinate minus tail coordinate. Head means which head? The arrow head, where the arrow is pointing. The arrow is pointing towards point P. These are the coordinates minus this coordinate. That way we can find out a vector R bar. So head coordinates here are R minus the tail coordinate is 0. So r minus 0 unit vector ar bar is 5. Head coordinate is 5, tail coordinate is 5 into a 5 bar. Then 0 minus z az bar. So r bar comes out to be r ar bar minus z az bar. Now I want to find out only magnitude, as it is needed here. Also for ar bar I need the magnitude. So the magnitude of r bar can be given as under root of r square plus z square, squaring and adding the magnitudes of r bar. So this is r bar, modulus of r bar. Now ar bar can be given as a vector upon its magnitude. The vector is this one, which I have written here. Upon its magnitude, the magnitude is here, which is written here. So I have found out dl bar. I know now ar, I know r. Now my job is to substitute all this in the equation of dh bar. Let us go and do that. So dh bar is I dz az. This is nothing but idl bar. R ar minus z az upon under root of r square plus z square. This is nothing but ar bar divided by 4 pi r square. R square is under root of r square plus z square whole bracket square. And this is in between is a cross product. So let us simplify this equation. When I simplify this equation, I get I dz az cross this bracket r ar minus z az upon 4 pi r square plus z square raised to 3 by 2. How it has come as 3 by 2? This is a square and this part is 1 half. So when I sum up, it comes out to be 3 by 2. Now my job is to find out this cross product. Which cross product? Az cross ar. When I am finding out the cross product, both should be vectors. So first vector is az, another vector is ar, then az cross az. This I need to find out. To find out the cross product, follow this triangle. Like if I want the cross product, for example, I want the cross product of ar and a5. Ar cross a5 will give me az. But if I do reverse, a5 cross ar, then in that case the answer will be minus of az. So in the same way here I want az cross ar. So az cross ar, as I am going in the same direction of the arrow, my result will be a5. So az cross ar is a5 and az cross az is 0. Remember, self cross product is always 0. So substitute these values in the above equation. So dh bar is I r dz a5, and this term has went to 0. So I got I r dz a5 upon the denominator is same, 4 pi r square plus z square raised to 3 by 2. Now fine, I have found out dh bar, but my intention is to find out h bar for the infinite length filament. So that h bar can be given as integral of dh bar, and the integration limits are from minus infinity to plus infinity because it's a infinite length filament. So let us substitute this dh bar here and let us find out h bar. So h bar can be given as integration minus infinity to plus infinity. This is the dh bar which we have calculated. Now I'll take out the constants outside and I'll get the equation like this. H bar is I R A phi divided by 4 pi into the integration sign dz upon r square plus z square raised to 3 by 2. So this term I need to integrate. As integration with dz, integration is with respect to z, so that this part is inside the integral, all others will be the constants which are taken outside the integral. Now this term I cannot directly find out its answer, so let us try to find out the integral of this part, and this can be done like this. I can solve this integral by substitution method. Substitute z equal to r tan theta. Dz comes out to be, when I differentiate this, dz is r tan, differentiation is sec square, r sec square theta d theta. At the same time, let us find out what will be the limits if I substitute. So limits will be like this. When z is tending towards infinity, theta will be tending towards pi by 2. When z is tending towards minus infinity, theta is tending towards minus pi by 2. So let us substitute this inside this bracket or in this integral. But before that, let us calculate this. What is r square plus z square raised to 3 by 2? If I substitute this, r square plus z as r tan theta, r square tan square theta raised to 3 by 2. This value comes out to be r square comes out as a constant outside, raised to 3 by 2, so that it comes out to be r cube, and inside the bracket there will be 1 plus tan square theta. 1 plus tan square is nothing but sec square. So sec square raised to 3 by 2 gives me sec cube theta. So that I can substitute this value and I can substitute dz, which is this one, at this place. So dh bar, this constant part as it is, instead of dz there comes r sec square theta d theta. Instead of this bracket it comes to be r cube sec cube d theta. R and r cancels out, here it remains r square. Sec square cancels out, here it remains sec theta. So integration is again this constant as it is, d theta divided by r square sec theta. Now again, 1 upon sec theta is nothing but cos theta d theta, and r square is constant which I can take outside the integral. Now integration is with respect to theta, and the inside the integral there will be cos theta d theta. So when I solve this integral, I get it as I r a phi upon 4 pi r square 1 minus of minus 1. So my answer comes out to be h bar is equal to I by 2 pi r a phi, unit of magnetic field intensity is amperes per meter. So this is the equation of h or h bar for infinite length filament. Let us look at this equation again and see what are the terminologies. So h bar is I by 2 pi r a phi bar amperes per meter, where I is nothing but a current which is flowing through the filament. R is the perpendicular distance between the filament and the point P where we desire the magnetic field. And here it's a scalar quantity. And A phi bar is the unit vector indicating the direction of magnetic field. Let us decide how to find the direction. So the direction of magnetic field intensity is given by right-handed thumb rule like this. Like if I hold the filament with my right hand and my thumb indicating the direction of the current, this thumb is indicating direction of current, then my curved fingers will be indicating the direction of magnetic field intensity. So this is the way we can decide the direction of the magnetic field. So this is the current direction, and this curved fingers will be indicating me the direction of magnetic field intensity. Here instead of H, B is shown. B and H are one and the same. B is the magnetic flux density. H is the magnetic field intensity. Only the difference is that there is a relation between B and H as B is equal to mu naught H. B can be given as mu naught H. So this is the method by which we can decide the direction. These are the references used for preparing this video. Thank you.